I think the main reason behind some of the concern is a lack of awareness of what the system actually provides. Where system accesses databases that are both public and commercial databases and court records that are accessible to anyone in the community, including yourself and the media. Our system, with Beware, is a system that is in real time. Instead of having to go out and do the research, it does the research for you and provides that information in real time within a matter of less than a minute to an operator. And the Beware system will automatically query that database to see who are the people that live there currently or in the past, and then provide cellular phone numbers, landline phone numbers, as well as if there's anyone in there that had a criminal offense. And then that information is then looked at by operators in the real-time crime center. It's really intended to provide the officer responding more information. The system will, if there is somebody that has a criminal history, it will have an asterisk by it. Our system does not look at social media. The Beware system allows for that, but our system has been deactivated, so where there is no social media monitoring that occurs. We disabled a second feature, which is a color coding threat assessment, red, yellow, green, and that has been taken out. We've been testing for the last 12 months in our center and made recommendations or suggestions as to how they can improve it. One of the council members sent a citizen through that had a concern, you know, obviously within reason, but if there are people that would like to take a tour of the real-time crime center and the systems we have in place, like gunshot detection, the Beware system, the video policing, with faith and community to collectively come up with some type of a policy as to how we would implement a social media program, social media monitoring program.